How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to be talking about what Torguard could be good for, as well as recommend three VPNs that could be a good alternative depending on your situation. So before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of the VPNs mentioned today, you'll find links to special deals and discounts that you won't otherwise find if you go to the VPN websites directly. So feel free to take advantage of those. You'll also find full in-depth reviews, giving you an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security features. So keep that in mind if you guys are interested. Now, Torguard is one of those VPNs that allow for probably the highest level of adjustment and configuration and customization within it. You know, as you can tell from the settings, you know, there are plenty of options all over the place, and advanced users will really appreciate the level of customization that Torguard offers. So Torguard could be a great option for those tech-savvy users looking for an open source application. They can kind of test, and not just that, you know, if you're looking for something that also allows for port forwarding, for example, or if you just want to pick your own ports here, for example, with OpenVPN, UDP, and TCP, you could pick your own cipher, be it 128 or 256, and all these port options here. Of course, you have Open Connect with OpenVPN, UDP, and TCP, and a WireGuard option. And if you go to the settings, you have a kill switch. Even appearance options, you're able to, you know, pick from all these different options, multiple auto connect options. And in the app kill switch, you do get to choose which applications are terminated when the VPN is disconnected. This is a rare feature that you don't see in many VPNs. You only get to see it in NordVPN. You can type your own connection scripts here. And in the network, you do get a DNS blocker. And in the network section here, you do get a kill switch, a DNS blocker, options to use custom DNS, so you can set your own custom DNS if you would like. And there are also preset DNS options, which is also another thing that you don't really see. So you can just go with the Google DNS and you'll be able to use that, or you can just turn it off if you don't need it. Of course, the edit option will allow you to set your own DNS if you would like. You also get proxy options, SOC 5 and HTTP. And with regards to servers, this is where you will get your dedicated IP for streaming. Unfortunately, I would not recommend Torguard for streaming services because they do allow for only three regions to be unblocked, and they'll give you three IP addresses to be used, as you can tell here how they've given me. And if you want to change regions, you'll actually have to pay. I think it was $4 to change regions, because they only give you three regions to access for streaming services. And if you ever want to change that, you'll have to pay $4 to change one of these regions, which is, I definitely would not recommend Torguard for unblocking streaming services. So, you know, the great thing, of course, about Torguard is how open source it is, how customizable it can get, and just, you know, the raw number of options available within the VPN. Now, many users could be deterred or perhaps intimidated by the amount of options and potential complexity of Torguard. So I do still have three suggestions for you guys. That'll be ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and Surfshark. Now, these are VPNs that are just super easy to use. There are no complications with regards to using them. They're very secure, provably very secure. They work very well with streaming services. You know, using Netflix as a reference, ExpressVPN is able to unblock up to 18 Netflix libraries, 10 with Nord and 15 with Surfshark. And ExpressVPN being specifically capable and very reliable and consistent when it comes to unblocking United States Netflix, which most VPNs struggle with. If that's what you're looking for, definitely go with ExpressVPN. It's got up to 94 countries and over 3,000 servers, and it'll allow you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription. And unlike Torguard, all of these VPNs do have split tunneling. Of course, if you didn't know what split tunneling is, split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through your VPN and which are not. So, you know, what you could do is perhaps, if you'd like to do so, only have your VPN affect your torrenting client while your entire network is left untouched by your VPN, or vice versa. Of course, you get a kill switch as well, a handful of protocols. and overall a very convenient experience when it comes to using ExpressVPN and all these VPNs for that matter. You know, if you're looking to secure one more device because perhaps five devices are not enough with ExpressVPN, you can get NordVPN. It'll allow you to secure six devices. You get specialty servers, you get custom DNS, you get obfuscated servers, split tunneling, not only an internet kill switch, a conventional kill switch, you also get an app kill switch, which Torguard also has. And you do get the powerful NordLynx protocol, making NordVPN the fastest VPN in the market today, about 3 to 5% faster than ExpressVPN, which is still very quick on both ends. ExpressVPN, which is still very fast, by the way, in ExpressVPN's case, but it's just that it's not quite as fast as the NordLynx protocol. But either way, they're both super quick. And of course, you get an ad blocker. And besides that, if you're looking for a VPN that secures an unlimited number of devices without having to use a compatible router, then Surfshark will definitely do that for you. And it being such a budget-friendly and cheap VPN does not mean that you're getting a cheap service. Now, on paper, Surfshark is less secure and slower than NordVPN and ExpressVPN, but that does not mean that it performs poorly. It performs very well. It's definitely up there with NordVPN and ExpressVPN, but I'm just saying that it's just not quite as fast as NordVPN and ExpressVPN. It's not that Surfshark is slow, it's just that NordVPN and ExpressVPN are that quick. Of course, you're still getting multi-hop and static IP, which is pretty much the same as double VPN and static IP, which, by the way, are available in NordVPN. You just have to switch to OpenVPN and you'll get access to dedicated IP and double VPN. Also, you're getting the whitelister, which is split tunneling, kill switch, and an ad blocker. And you're getting a WireGuard protocol and a ShadowSox proxy protocol, which you also saw, by the way, in Torguard. Just keep in mind that the ShadowSox protocol will only secure your browser traffic, but it will help you reach banned websites if you're in a censorship-heavy country. And if you're in China, it'll help you bypass the Great Firewall of China using no borders mode. So yeah, overall, these three VPNs will cater to, I would say, over 90% of VPN users, be it in terms of performance, security, features, and even budgets. I mean, you've got all types of prices here, from ExpressVPN being the most premium service and, well, also a service that comes with a premium price. And then you've got NordVPN with plenty of features and at a more affordable price. And then you've got the most affordable option, Surfshark, without cheapening out on performance and security, of course. So again, if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. Besides that, thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.